creators to the Underground Laboratory, where together we are going to be creating some awesome comics, because this is Making Comics 101. 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 I'm Scott Serkland, and this is Making Comics 101. This is going to be such an awesome series. We're going to talk about every aspect of making comics. Getting started. Ideas. Plotting, world building, scripting, penciling, inking, coloring, lettering, perspective, publishing, and so much more. Now, there are a few things that every good story needs. Now, first, what we need to do is we need to establish the characters. What's the recipe for creating an awesome hero? When you're designing a costume for your superheroes, the colors you choose play a tremendous role. Let's pinpoint the visual traits that make for a compelling villain. Villains are just plain fun to draw, and writing dialogue for a megalomaniac, I mean, forget about it. I mean, it's the best. We're finally kind of getting into some of the nitty-gritty of our story. Make your stories as fantastical as you want. You can go absolutely crazy with your ideas. So I think these prompts are really going to help to create a roadmap for you to follow when creating your story, when plotting it out. Your thumbnail should be super loose. The main objective is just to get your ideas on the page. I can recommend my favorite tools, but really, there's no right or wrong tools when it comes to creating comics. Creating comics digitally can save you a ton of time, but you could argue that you lose some of that organic nature of the art form. Panels are a storytelling device that are unique only to comics. Perspective is one of the hardest and most challenging aspects of creating comics, but modern tools have made it a whole lot easier. For me, sound effects is one of my favorite aspects that comics has to offer. Just think of the sound of a big beastly creature swinging a tree trunk at our superhero. I mean, what does that sound like? Since digital coloring was introduced and popularized in the 90s, it's revolutionized the look of comics, but things were a little rocky there in the beginning. How do you present your ideas? You need to sum it up concisely. You need an elevator pitch. The best way to learn how to make comics is by creating comics. I mean, I love creating comics. It's a part of who I am, and I imagine if you're watching this, you probably feel the same way. And you can do it. Anyone can create a comic, and I'm gonna show you how. You wanna learn how to make comics? This is the show for you.
Hey, thanks for watching. If you like what you saw and you want to see more, hit that subscribe button. Also, you can follow me at Serkworks on social media, and now you can support the work that I do on Patreon. Do you like making comics? Then go to Serkworks.com and pick up the Comic Maker Starter Kit. It's packed full of fonts, brushes, templates, and more. And best of all, it's totally free!